afternoon. My name is David Morris, also known as 239354 or 41216. What does that mean? It means I have a criminal past. It means I have sold drugs. I have been caught drinking and driving. I have made mistakes. Nevertheless, I haven't let my trials or tribulations define me. Did I make the best choices? No. Was there some blessing or something that's good that came out of it? Yes. I come from a place where opportunity is few and far between. I never thought I would be in the position that I'm in. I never thought that I would have the ability to use my voice for those that cannot speak, or for those that have been in shackles and the law has been by the balls. Thus, they will never get out the system. I grew up in Chicago. The only thing I graduated from was kindergarten. My mom didn't have custody, and I never knew my dad. I lived with my grandmother until she passed when I was nine. When I was 10, I was kicked out of my guardian's house. As far back as I can remember, I bounced from home to home until my late teens. At one point, I went through 9 schools in 4 years. In no family, I tried to find my mom. During that process, I encountered Thomas Dixon. While mentoring me at 11 or 12, he learned I was homeless and opened his doors to me. He became my father. In the effort to reconnect with my mom, I followed my mom to multiple states, only to return back to Chicago. I grew up isolated, punished and pushed out. By 16, I had my first job. By 17, I was full time. After serving 3.5 years for a drug dispense, I was determined to start making better decisions. One of the best decisions I made, in 2009, I moved to Minneapolis. When I made it here, I wanted the best for my life. I literally started from the bottom by going to MNIC to get my GED. At 22, going to school with really young kids, really hungry. But I was determined to right my wrongs, not only for my kids, but to help my community as well. I interned with Tree Trucks at Urban Homeless to start preparing for the GED test. Then I received 4 great things to happen. One, I received my GED. I started a business management class. I graduated from my internship early, and I landed 2 jobs. I was proud of myself. Steve Morgan, a project manager at Tree Trust, had noticed my work ethic and loved it. He formally introduced me to Russ Barkley at Urban Homeworks, and I was hired on as a crew leader through AmeriCorps that summer. As I was working on summer day in 2012, Ryan Cummings and the owner Pat Ryan came to volunteer at the Urban Homeworks site. Pat Ryan enjoyed my experience. He enjoyed his experience so much that he invited me to lunch with him. As a family, he took time to really learn my story and get to know me. One thing stood out from that, he wanted to sponsor me until he knew me. At this point in my journey, I had still had the screaming mentality, loyalty over worlds. I discussed the pros and cons with Urban Homeworks, and they encouraged me to go and experience carpentry at a special menu. It was hard for me to leave Urban Homeworks family because I was really happy. But I started seeing those checks, so I quickly became a cocky 23-year-old kid that mentally wasn't ready to make that type of money. With a drug background, all I knew was how to blow it. Never saved me. Saving never even registered to me. After rent was paid, everything came in and went right back out. I started partying hard, drinking and driving, not caring about being as driven as I once was. In 2013, after being laid off, I ended up being locked up for a DUI because of my recklessness. Wow. That really humbled me again. This time I lost so much. I felt ashamed, stupid, and lonely. I felt like life was over. But in this moment of shame, there was 2 defining moments that prepared me for through that. First, I was in my cell. I received a visit from Russ Barkley. He cannot stay long, but he took 5 hours. It took 1.5 hours to drive and to deliver a message. I will never forget the words he said. You are not alone. I love you, brother. I'm in your corner. Wow. Man took 5 hours out of his busy day to deliver a 5-minute conversation to me. The man you grew up know, I finally started a support system. Second defining moment was after my incarceration, Bob Alcorn and his wife, Ms. Pat. And I was a crew leader. I worked beside him several days a week, and I began to see him as a granddad and his wife, Ms. Pat, as a grandma. Especially since I lost my mother at an early age. I was at a halfway house working at Burger King in the Brooklyn Center. One day, Bob came to see me and asked me, "Have you hit your rock bottom yet?" I finally realized, I told him, I regret leaving Urban Homeworks because it's not just an organization or a job, but it's my family and I left my family. He told me he was still in my corner. Soon after my encounter with Bob, I was informed that another cruising position had opened up. I was excited, but I also knew I was running out of lifelines. This time I had to stay humble and driven, but I also knew that I had family behind me supporting me. I've been back to Urban Homeworks for 2 years now. As a staff member and as a leader, I've been taking on different roles in the organization, constantly wanting to learn more and do more to help those that have a similar story as mine. I've been encouraged and promoted. Now I walk with families that's trying to find housing. I am a voice for those who change, but they still struggling in the fence. They're still looking for that one good opportunity. I have been denied many opportunities for many reasons, too many to count. I always said, you have enough income, but you have a drug conviction from 4 years ago. Or hey, I want to give you a job, but you don't have any experience. Or even better yet, we want to give you assistance, but you're making them. How? I'm a father still trying to improve, and yet a lot of doors is closed to me. I decided I wanted better for my life and for my kids' life. Hell, I want to be a guide to a youth that's been through the same thing I have. Mom not being around, father don't know, or parents that just really don't have the opportunity. Not having family there, I know that feeling. I also learned that there's people out there that do care about them. Russ, Steve, Chad, Caroline, Thomas, Bob, and Ms. Applecorn. That's my support system. Urban Homeworks is my family. This relationship for me wasn't just about construction, an internship, a place to stay, or even a job. It was the entire network that showed me who I truly am and who I have the power to become and what that means for my family and my community. As me and Urban Homeworks walk together as family, our doors are open for you to become our extended family. Thank you.